this week's episode, we'll be meeting the Gophers.
Hold on,
Gophers! Gophers? What do you mean, Gophers? Gophers!
Arthur Burrows meets the Gophers.
Now I'm going to need some garlic and a crucifix.
And now, read on.
Careful, Frank! I ask you, whoever heard of a crow with a fear of heights?
Whoever heard of a crow with no brain? Anyway, what's the point of getting up? Nothing ever happens around here. I'm going back to sleep.
New people moving in this morning?
Good night.
Transmorphosis machine, product of my scientific genius. Now that I have disposed of those foul frogs, I can move into their house, beneath which is buried the crystal. Yes, the crystal! With its unimaginable power, I shall become the all-powerful, all-evil, super ferret Dr. Wins! Ha ha!
Yes, Mother. Please. No, I haven't left yet. Yes, everything's turned off. I've cancelled the papers, darling, yes. Yes. Goodbye, Mummy. I'll call you just as soon as I've moved in. Yes.
Now, where is Sly? He only went out to pick up the keys.
Yes, indeed, Sly. You repulsive reptile! We must go, and quickly, my house and my crystal await. Sly, bring the crates. Yes?
I'm afraid they've sold the house to somebody else.
What? Who else?
A family of golfers. They paid more money than you.
Gophers? What do you mean, gophers?
It's moving day, moving day. If you can't pay the rent, you gotta live out in a tent because it's moving day. Oh, I ain't moving house, great kids.
No, it ain't. I need the bathroom and fast. And let's have some real music. Let me.
Silence is golden. Lovely cup of tea, dear.
Yes, Arthur, here it is.
Thank you, dear. You mind out, Flora. It's a known fact that the majority of accidents in the home happen in the kitchen.
I know that, Dad. I have to eat most of them. When are the new neighbours moving in?
Oh, today sometime. I heard it was a ferret. I do hope not. Oh. They're the most unpleasant of creatures.
Oh, no, the frogs were bad enough.
The frog family was very nice, dear.
All their kids ever wanted to do was go swimming. I've never seen a family take so many baths. And the whole place was knee-deep in frog spawn.
Well, I'm off out into the garden. A fine breakfast, Beatrix. Most important meal of the day, that's what I always say.
Well, that's good, dear, because there's an extremely trivial lunch.
Hmm? Good morning, legumes.
So, what I'm saying, brothers...
Oi!
Sorry, sister. Mm. Brothers and sisters, is we must do something about it. They tear us out of the ground one by one and...
And what?
Well, none of us know, but they take us away somewhere. And have you ever known a cabbage come back?
I once saw a few dead leaves on the compost heap.
Oh, we're all going to be eaten, one by one. Don't fool yourselves. Things couldn't be any worse.
stop now. Anyways, I got some geek on my tail. Hey, you! Out of my way! Kids can use the bathroom when we get back.
I can't stand the smell in here. Will you let me out?
No, I will not!
Oh, come on, Pa. Don't drive so fast, boy.
Health teeth, backseat drivers. My Uncle Zeke drove all his life and never a word from the backseat.
Yes, sweetheart, but he drove a hearse. Now go slow.
Oh, my Lord, I do believe we're there. Hold on!
My veggies.
Oh, goodness.
My beautiful vegetables.
Quick, Mom. Give me the baby.
Here.
Junior, let's find a bathroom. Come on. Oh, hi, y'all.
Hi.
We're your new neighbors.
Aww.
Ye gods, another woman with hairy legs.
Chuck.
Listen, I see y'all in a minute, but, well, nature's truly calling. Coming, nature! Listen,
yeah.
I'm real sorry about the fence. At least some of it's still standing.
Yeah.
Now, let's go find a job. Come on, kids.
See you later.
Come on, boy.
Never mind, dear. At least no one was hurt.
My foot! Beatrix!
Lovely cup of tea, dear.
Apparatus at the ready, Sly.
At the ready, sir!
Don't push me, Junior! Hey, Big Hose, where's the can?
Thanks!
Big Hose?
Yes.
What in the name of heck are you doing?
Shh. Aha! What was that?
She said.
Ah! Oh.
What in the name of heck are you doing?
Oh, shut up, Sly. Madam, you must be the new occupier.
We sure are, and you ain't supposed to be here. Chuck, get in here!
Oh, no. I'm afraid I've some very unpleasant news for you and your family. My assistant and I are here from the Institute of Incredibly Scary Things, and for some time now we have suspected this house is home to poltergeists, phantoms, quite hideous demons, and murderous specters. Sly, demonstrate the specter detection machine.
Yes, sir!
Quite. So you see, the terrifying evil in this house is almost too much for both the machine and my assistant Sly's brain to comprehend. This house is haunted.
Mister, are you saying this house is haunted?
Yes, very much so, I'm afraid. Very haunted.
Haunted?
Young man, it is quite extraordinarily dangerously haunted.
Did I hear someone say this house is haunted?
Yes! Gordon Bennett, haunted! You're all going to die unless you leave very quickly. Do I have to spell it out for you?
Wow, far out! Oh, Chuck, isn't this great? Our own little country house, and it's haunted. Ain't that quaint?
Yeah, folks back home will be green with jealousy when they hear this.
Yeah. What? You mean you're not frightened?
Oh, heck no. We've seen all the movies. Why, ghosts don't scare us one itsy-witsy little bit.
You mean you're not going to leave? Screaming, terrified, your bag still packed, never to return, like he said you would?
Shut up, Sly!
No way. This is the best news we've had all day.
Yeah, and if you folks will excuse us, we got some moving in to do.
Yeah, I gotta unpack. I'm going up to my room to look for ghosts.
Be warned, ghosts and ghouls are not things to be treated lightly. Mysterious and untimely deaths occur. You must tread carefully! A cockroach! I hate cockroaches! Oh, come, Sly, back to the laboratory.
Nobody home.
La cucaracha, la cucaracha, la 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 la.
Hey, Milagros, a new country. We made it. Whew, what a journey, huh?
See, stuck in a packing case for 4,000 miles.
Rough trip for cockroaches, no?
Yeah, but I feel okay. Hey, where's Nacho?
Oh, man, I come all this way and I get stepped on. What a bummer.
Man, Natch, don't let things get on top of you, man.
Mum, Dad, oh, come on, look on the bright side. It could have been more frogs.
My fence! They broke my fence!
It was just an accident, dear. I'm sure they'll be nice, respectable, quiet.
Hello! Hiya!
Here's the gophers!
Here's the gophers!
Hi there! I'm Chuck, this here's Junior, and little baby Chipper. I guess we're your new neighbors, and I reckon we're all gonna get along fine. What a pretty little place you have here. Listen, I'm real sorry about the fence. Guess we got off on the wrong foot. Ha! There I go saying the wrong thing. Anyways, first thing I'm gonna do is fix it for y'all.
I'll fix it. It's only minor destruction.
Hey, I'll do it.
Leave it to me.
Yeah, well, as soon as Lily and my darling wife's finished unpacking, we're gonna invite you over. Bye now. Hey, you didn't introduce yourselves.
I am Arthur Burrows, and this is my wife, Beatrix.
Hello.
And I'm Flora.
Well, ain't that cute? Bye.
Cut that out, Junior, and quit picking those flowers.
Well, there's a turn up for the books. There we all were, living peacefully, leading charmed lives. And what happens?
Hey, I clean forgot. Is your place haunted too? Apparently, next door is full of wang doodles and ghouls. Ah.
Quaint. Haunted houses are quaint. Are they mad? Well, Sly, if it's a haunting they want, then it's a haunting they'll get. They will run screaming from Sycamore Heights. We must have that crystal at all costs.
Can I ask you a question, please, Dr. Wins?
Put your hand up first. You with your hand up. What is your question?
Why do you want to become all-powerful and rule over everybody? Exactly.
Why? Because does night not follow day? Does death not follow life? Does Wince not lust after power?
Oh, I see.
This ought to make Artie happy.
Gopher?
Uh-oh.
You are standing in my vegetable patch.
I am fixing your fence. Look, I'm just trying to put right what I done. Now, will you cool it?
I am overwhelmed that you should patch up my fence, but if you could please get off my vegetables.
Oh, gee, yeah, I'm sorry. Hey, Artie, listen, what do you say we all get our families together later? You know, have a housewarming barbecue out in the yard of our haunted house. How about it, neighbor?
Haunted? Really? Why do you believe such nonsense?
No, listen, it's really true. They found every kind of wang doodle and spook in that house of ours. I reckon this is gonna boost tourism to this area. It'll put Sycamore Heights right on the map.
Ooh, ooh, beware, beware. All who live here will die ghastly and foul deaths. I will avenge this disturbance!
Yes, well, we don't want to be put on the map. It's all childish, superstitious drivel. Ghost?
You see, Artie, I was telling you, there's one of them wang doodles. Artie?
You see, madam, a poltergeist in the kitchen can be a very dangerous thing indeed. They can play with your electrical implements.
What?
Imagine the stark terror of an out-of-control electrical carving knife! Whoa! Yes. I'm not sure what the next one is. Yes, a vicious blender. Poltergeists can also throw things around. What? Look over there!
Ow!
And over there!
That's incredible!
And very scary, yes? Yes. And I think the poltergeist has one more cup left. Look over there!
Stop it! This is unbelievable. And look at that cake, won't you?
Oh, no! A poltergeist!
Hey, come back! Don't be scared! Watch
you look at that cake?
Hey, this place ain't so bad. They just let you take their food.
Cake!
Qué bueno!
Hey, the little green one, he was so scared, he just ran off screaming.
Nice one, Loop. Welcome to the new country, amigos. Yum, yum! Hi, hon. I invited the rabbits over for a barbecue later. Hey, what's all this smashed plate stuff?
Oh, Chuck, you have never seen anything like it. A poltergeist threw cups around the kitchen, and then he carried off our cake.
Well, screwball things don't happen.
I don't know how much I like it, darling. What if the wang doodles turn mean?
Hun, the moment they get you down is when I call in the services of an exorcist or a spook spanker. Don't you worry none.
Oh. Oh, oh, Junior.
Who you gonna call?
Junior, you protect your ma while I stick up the old Gopher family portrait here. Hey, where'd you get all that gear?
The spook spankers left it behind. I'm gonna go back to the garden and track me some spooks. Bye.
Bye. Chuck!
What's that, darling?
Chuck.
How about that, then, Ollie? They've smashed his fence, squashed his vegetables. Arthur must be going mad.
Careful, Frank. You don't want to fall.
Oh, be quiet, Ollie. This is the most excitement we've had here in ages. Those gophers are really going to shake things up around here.
Oi!
Oh, no, no, I'm going to fall.
I've got you.
Glory. That was a close one.
Yeah.
Evil dead. Maybe I can get a spirit reading.
Excuse me, but I am not dead. Kindly leave me alone.
Of course. You are undead. You foul messenger from hell. You shall not have my mother's soul. I know. I need a wooden stake and a hammer to drive through the heart of this fiend. Stay here. I'll be right back.
I'm a crow. I live here. I fell out of a tree. I'd better hop it.
I'm worried, Beatrix. Very worried. This is a living nightmare.
Oh, for heaven's sake, Arthur. You imagined you saw a ghost. You're under stress with a new neighbour's coming. Just try and relax. Lovely cup of tea?
This is no time for tea, woman. I know what I saw. It was horrible. Ah, here we are.
What's the book, Dad?
A home study course on exorcism. The book club sent it instead of Azalea's My Way. It is no coincidence that this all started with those gophers. Chuck is quite clearly demented and therefore a source of hysterical amusement to the spirit world who follow him around for laughs. That must be it.
I've never heard so much nonsense. Anyway, we'll go to their barbecue tonight and you can sort it all out. But for goodness sake, behave yourself! And do try not to get so worked up.
Worked up? Who's worked up? I'm being quite sensible about this. Ah! Now I'm going to need some garlic and a crucifix.
Huh? Oh, where's that evil fiend from hell gone to? Whoa, whoa, I'm getting a reading. Oh, hell's teeth, there's something mighty powerful down there. Woo, woo!
I must have that crystal. How can this be? The gauntless gophers are going to pay dearly for their meddling. Sly? Sly, where are you, you scaly simpleton?
Here, sir. Here I am. I'm frightened.
Of course you are, Sly. I am a very frightening person, aren't I?
Not you. That haunted house. It's so scary. Please don't make me go back there again, sir. Please.
Don't be stupid, Sly. We are doing the haunting.
But in the kitchen?
Idiot! That was me, brilliantly disguised.
As a piece of cake?
I have been too subtle with them. We shall go back, Sly, and terrify them with one final and totally spectacular demonstration of the paranormal. I will, just for one evening, become death himself. Nothing will prevent me from possessing the crystal. Nothing. Come, we must prepare.
Here we go again!
Yep, food ain't never so good as when it's cooked in the great outdoors.
Where's that kerosene, Junior?
Where's Arthur? He is coming, ain't he? Is he still mad at Chuck?
No, not exactly. He thought he saw a ghost this afternoon, and it's had rather an odd effect on him.
Oh, let me tell you. It's very worrying. I had a terrible scare this afternoon. We don't know what to do.
Dad, what are you doing?
Just taking precautions. You never know where evil may strike.
Junior, bring the kerosene here.
You have the thunder flashes.
Yes, Dr. Death.
This is heavy, Dad. Hey, you ruined the food yet?
Kerosene, folks. Best and quickest barbecue fuel there is.
No, it ain't, Pa. Remember the last time? I'm putting this drum over by the wall as far away from you as I possibly can.
Pantywaist kid. Hey, Artie, you brung some garlic. That's good. Hey, I dig your gear.
Yow!
Me?
Yes, the ugly one. This is your final warning. Take your family and leave this place, or I must come for you! Whoa. Now, Sly, now! Leave now, or the icy knuckles of death will whack you on the nose!
Antelinum! Trifolium! Get thee gone and go back home again! Please?
You puny rodent! Cower before my power! Now, Sly, Thunderflash!
No! Wait, Sly, wait! Fight against might, your time has come, so be gone and take flight. What? I say.
Gee, Artie.
Artie, you did it. He's gone. You saved us. Thank you.
Oh,
thank you.
Well, it was nothing, really.
You are a true friend and neighbor, Artie. I tell you this, me and my family ain't never going to let you forget this. Never!
Oh, what a brilliant disguise, Dr. Wentz. After everything that happened to you, to go back as a mummy. Oh, you're so brave.
No, fool. It's because nearly every bone in my body has been broken. Oh.